Introducing the Rutenbar family. Steve, Connie, Missy, David, and Don. Ready for action. And the Dustin family. Dent, Cindy, Teresa, Debbie, and Tammy. On your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome. I'm the guest host for tonight. Johnny's off. may click somewhere and they'll say, what a great idea. Well, I won't need you, of course, Gene. Now, we get together once or twice a week, have a nice time, meet two nice families, not necessarily tonight, but usually two nice families. One of them get a chance to go for $10,000. Let's see who we have. Rutenbar! How are you, Steve? You're all very big now. Somebody just pushed the down button on my elevator. Who've you got here, Rascal?
I've got my wife, Connie, my sister, Missy, my brother, David, and Connie's brother, Don.
What do you do, Steve?
I'm a freelance writer. My wife and I just moved back out here from graduate school in Chicago.
Yeah? Well, you write short stories?
A lot of short stories, fiction pieces, yeah. Anything that'll sell.
Sold anything good lately that we might have read?
Not that you would have read, Richard, probably.
Why? I'd swear to you, I read. I love to read.
I've been writing mostly for children's magazines.
Would you give me a couple of your stories? Let me read them.
Sure will.
Place them in a couple of good places. Great. Where I put most of my stuff, in the birdcage. Every time we don't get to call Dustin. Hi. Yeah. How you doing, sir?
Hi, Dave.
Nice to see you. Good company here. Who you got?
Yes, Richard, I brought my four lovely daughters. My oldest, Cynthia, Teresa, Deborah, and my youngest, Tammy, down there on the end.
Toothpaste ads. All great smiles. You must have a heck of a dentist.
Well, yeah.
Toothbrush someplace.
Are you a dentist?
Yes, I'm a dentist.
This area, which way? Up and down.
Up and down. Right.
Always up and down, huh?
Up and down, right.
Never side, side.
Never side, side.
Always up and down.
Up and down. Inside and out.
The worst thing, I can't get the stuff to stay on this box.
Well, you know.
Does he do all your teeth up there?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Sure.
Well, it's certainly paying off here.
All got lovely smiles.
Well, this is professional. It says not for sale.
Not for sale, right.
Well, I can get that off and sell it.
Okay.
Gene, I want to see you on the very next commercial. I got a very good thing, but first we have to play the view. Let's go! Come on, Gene. Now, gentlemen. For the very first question, yeah, you should get on your knees. You're still, I mean, here we are. We're just a couple of reasonable heights.
The way up there.
Yeah, he is tall, but he's a very good. 100 ladies this first time. Just 100 ladies. No men. Okay? 100.
Ladies.
Okay. Like Lenny of Mice and Men, isn't it? I want to play with the rabbit. Okay, 100 when we ask them. Top 7 answers are up there on the board. You know, you got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. He said to 100 women, name a famous man you'd like to see in the Mr. Nude America contest.
Burt Reynolds.
Ah. Burt Reynolds. Yeah. Excellent. One answer will beat it, however.
Can't think of one right offhand. Take your toothbrush.
Okay,
I got it.
You can throw it. What are you going to do?
Play it.
We want to play it.
Yeah, I think they really do. They're going to play it. All righty. How are you, sweetheart?
Fine.
Nice to see you.
Can
you
I
also
say hi to some friends in Chicago?
Oh, of course you can. We'll do that right after the show. Could you name a famous man you'd like to see in the Mr. Nude America contest?
Robert Redford.
Oh, all right. Robert Redford! I'm just going to make an exception because that was the number one answer. Who are these people in Chicago?
Steve and Nancy. They were our trainers while we were back there.
Trainers?
Yeah, for the feud.
Oh, all right, Steve. Oh, well, then you're doing good work. Excellent. How are you? Good. Famous man, we asked 100 women. Famous man, you'd like to see in the Mr. Nude America contest.
Paul Newman.
Ah. Any of the 100 ladies say Paul Newman? Oh, yeah, Paul. Oh, he's dropped very bad, isn't he? How you doing?
All right.
What do you think?
I think Charles Bronson.
Oh, all right. Old granite face. Charlie! Not there. He's in good shape, though. That's a strike. You get three of those, they get a chance to steal. Nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Remember we asked 100 women? Name a famous man you'd like to see in the Mr. Nude America contest.
John Travolta.
Oh, hey. John Travolta! There we go. When I die, you know, that's what I want him to sing. Staying alive. What do you think?
They can't all be winners.
Came on an MC, I'm going off a straight man. And a short straight man at that. Now, what do you think, sir?
How about Clint Eastwood?
Okay.
Good answer.
Show us Clint Eastwood!
Oh,
see, I was rooting for him, even though you caught me. Come on, Connie. Famous man you'd like to see in the Mr. Nude America contest.
I'm going
to
try Johnny Carson.
All right.
Uh-huh.
When they say they really mean it, here's Johnny! Not there. Second strike. Missy.
Steve McQueen.
Oh, okay. Steve McQueen's up there. You're okay. If not, third strike. Steve McQueen! Not there. Hey, Jen, you can get all that money. What do you say?
John Davidson.
Oh, I got all of his records. John Davidson's up there. $61 for you. If not, we'll give it to Steve. John Simple Davidson. Not there. You got it. Number three, please. Listen, any Paul, we have some sisters with us. Normally, yeah. Any Paul that I can beat, Paul Newman, Clint Eastwood, and John Travolta, normally I would have stripped. And I do thank those 100 people who voted, the 100 ladies. And I hope you didn't regret it when you sobered up. Let's take a look at number 7. Ah, the dreaded Snake Stallone. $61 there, nothing. Let us do it. Come on. Fame is so fleeting, isn't it? Goodness me. Well, 300 points, by the way, will win this game. Give you a chance to go for $10,000. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something you pack in the little inside pockets of a suitcase. Yeah.
Underwear.
Okay, 10 people said that. Connie, 2 answers better than that.
I'll try toothbrush.
Toothbrush! You got it. What are you going to do?
Play. We're going to play.
She's so embarrassed. Yeah, that's what they gave me.
Good.
I should put this in the suitcase. Name something you pack in the little inside pockets of a suitcase.
Makeup.
All right.
Good.
Looking for makeup?
I'll say tie.
Ties? Okay. David and his ties. Nope. Been canceled, and that's a strike. Stop.
I'll say socks.
You will, and it sounds like a goodie. Show us socks. $75, 2 answers left. Name something you pack in the little inside pockets of a suitcase.
A razor would fit real nice.
Yeah.
Good answer.
Like to see a razor. Not there. Second strike, Connie.
Oh, I'm going to try money.
You are?
Yeah.
Okay. Money's up there. You're all right. If not, third strike. And then Dustin get a chance to steal once again. Money. Not there. Then here's your chance.
Okay. Money.
Sanitary napkins.
Very nicely put. Yeah. We couldn't have stopped when I came forth in the Mr. Nude America. All right, if those things are up there, get $75. If not, of course, you will get a big lead, and you deserve a big lead. Are they there? Wow. Number five, please.
Jewelry.
So, of course, so obvious, isn't it? Number six. Comb and brush. Well, I won't be doing any more of this, so... Well, you'll see what's happening after this commercial. Bye-bye. Something else you can put in that little pocket in the suitcase. It's the home version of the Family Feud game, available at three stores in America. All the rest will say, well, sorry, we're out. Anyway, you're going to get one of those, all right? 136? Hey, okay. Nothing there? Come on. Remind you, $300 gives you a chance to go for 10,000. 100 people surveyed, top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Tell me something a Californian is more likely to have than a New Yorker is. Yeah.
Surfboard.
Surfboard! Very good answer. Two answers will be it.
Bathing suit.
Bathing suit? Not there, you control it. What are you going to do?
We're going to play.
All right. David, something a Californian is more likely to have than a New Yorker is.
Got to have a suntan.
Okay, show us a tan. 65 people said it, huh?
A sports car.
Okay, any about 100 people say sports car. Yeah. You got it. One more, you got it all, Steve. Something California is more likely to have than a New Yorker is.
Oh.
Hypnosis for you.
Seen a lot of tacky leisure suits out here.
Well, not mine, pal. 9 polyesters died to make this. Leisure suits, there you got it all. If not, first strike, leisure suits. What do you say, Angel?
I think I'll try a swimming pool.
Swimming pool, all right. Swimming pool's there, clean sweep. If not, second strike. Swimming pool! You got it! They got all the money. 227, nothing here. Let's go! All right, little Debbie, this is for luck. Now, you got to get in this game because the dollar values are doubled. If they win it, they're going to play for the big money, all right? 100 people surveyed, top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name someone who uses a net. Yeah.
Volleyball player.
Volleyball player. Not there. Someone who uses a net.
A tennis player.
A tennis player. Name someone who uses a net, Don.
A basketball player.
Basketball player. Someone who uses a net, my love.
A fisherman?
Fisherman? Gonna play, gonna pass.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play. Oh, I'm so proud of you. I haven't even met you. Sam, someone who uses a net, please.
Someone who uses a net.
I know.
3 seconds.
Ping pong player.
Ping pong player. PPP, ping pong player? Not there. First strike, Cindy.
I'd have to say a fireman.
You would. Show us fireman.
Okay.
Someone who uses a net.
Someone who works around food, or a cook, or they have to have their hair in a net.
Cooks up there, you're all right. If not, third strike, and they get a chance to get it all. A cook? Out there. Steve, you can get it. Clean sweep.
Hey, what do you have?
Dog catcher.
Acrobat.
Need an answer. Come on.
We like dog catchers.
You do. Dog catcher's there. You'll play for $10,000. If not, Dent, you're in this game. Dog catcher. I don't know what's there. Did you hear the other one they gave? Which is kind of good. an acrobat. I don't know if it's there, but an acrobat or an aerialist. That would probably... Let's see number three, please.
Oh,
yeah, trapeze. They had both of those. And number four. Butterfly catcher. Well, it's rather embarrassing. It doesn't mean you want your toothbrush back, though, does it?
I do not.
No?
No.
No. Where are you a dentist, by the way, Dan?
In Montebello area.
Where is that? Is that near here?
East Los Angeles.
No, because we've all had a lot of trouble here with our teeth, so we could come down and see you.
Come down.
Oh, we all work for one.
Oh, the hell with him. I'll come and see you.
Oh, okay, or her.
Hey, thank you for being
very
here.
Nice.
We got nice prizes for all of you. You're a sweetheart. I never got down to see any of you. You're all so pretty. Do you work with your
father?
I do. Thank you. Thank you. Who's going to play for the money? Let's go.
Come on, you guys.
Who'll go first? You'll go first?
Coward.
Six D's rolling for the money right after we watch this. All right. Now, we have Connie off stage, earphones on. Man's impersonating a vase. Yeah, put your... Very casual, eh? You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, fine. All right. Gonna, Connie cannot hear us. Give me 15 seconds. I'm playing for $10,000. Want you to get it, Steve. Oh, here we go. Name something a dog does to tell you how he feels.
Wag his tail.
A word that rhymes with pink.
Think.
An American-made car.
Ford.
A wife's most important duty.
To love her husband.
Storm with heavy winds.
Hurricane.
Turn around, Steve. You play well. Here you go. Let's see how well you did. Help a big brother, won't you? Won't you help somebody? I've been so happy since I met Steve. All little children need a big brother and a sister that looks like his wife's aunt. That name's something a dog does to tell you how he feels, and you said, the old wag the tail guy. Our survey said, 32. Beautiful. Word that rhymes with pink, and you said, think. Our survey said, 13. American-made car, you said, Ford, our survey said, 37. We got 82. Wife's most important duty. Very nice thought. You said love her husband. Is that correct? Very nice. I love that. Our survey said, 5. No, as always, the lovely answers that come from the heart are right into the tube. Storm with heavy winds, you said, hurricane. Our survey said, ah, come on, let's make her feel good. Here's Connie. Come on, darling. You are only 61 points away. He did so well. He got 139 points. 61 points from $10,000. Gonna ask you the same questions. I'm gonna ask, you know, that I asked Crazy Steve.
Right.
And you must not duplicate his answers. If you do, you hear this, okay? Then I'll say try again. You give me another answer. Okay. We want you to get it. Everybody, please, all mentally at least, cross your fingers. This is a nice young couple. Please remind everyone the answer Steve gave us before he grew in a foot. And give me, 20 seconds. Well, I feel like that. Ready, Don?
Okay.
Name something a dog does to tell you how he feels.
Wag the tail.
Try again.
Lick you.
A word that rhymes with pink.
Stink.
An American-made car.
Ford.
Try again.
Chevy.
A wife's most important duty.
House cleaning.
A storm with heavy winds.
Hurricane.
Try again.
A tornado.
Tornado. There you go. Name something a dog does to tell you how he feels. And you said, he licks you. They do that.
Yep.
My dog used to do that. He saves bathing. Our survey said, 3. He barks. He barks. That's the number one answer. Word that rhymes with pink. And you said, stink. Our survey said, 20.
Okay.
That was the number one answer. Stink. 38 points away. An American-made car. You said, Chevy. Our survey said, 30.
Okay.
Ford was number one. And now you're 8 points from $10,000. Wife's most important duty. You said house cleaning, if it's worth 8 points, $10,000 richer. Our survey said. Well, see, that explains it. I was standing in a hole. They got $10,383. We'll see you here on the Feud.
Some departing good message.
It keeps jamming. What are we going to do?
Kick it? We'll kick it.
Hey, you want to grab some lunch?
Yes, but not with the dweebs from accounting.
Coffee any good today?
No, but I'm hooked.
You'll be buzzing all week from Game Show Network's Sunday Night Buzz. First is Lingo, then Chuck Woolery Naturally Stone, GSN's first reality show. Then comics go joke to joke on National Lampoon's Funny Money. Plus, be sure to check out Cram. Catch a buzz that'll last all week. Sunday Night Buzz, Sundays at 9, Eastern and Pacific.
America's turning to screwball and the lather machine and dentine chewing gum. While you're chewing, it freshens your breath as effectively as mouthwash. Brush your breath with dentine and the windbreaker and STP son of a gun. Helps restore and beautify vinyl, leather, and rubber. Just spray it on and you'll say, son of a gun. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.